Okay, what's up, everyone? It's Schlex.
And it's your boy Southwest Bully, the one and only.
I want mine like that. I want a little. I want a little jingle. Like,
yeah,
there is only one Schlex too. Like, there's only one.
Oh shit! We'll figure tatted. It out.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. The one and only, because I dance with you. I'm like I mouth it with you. I'm like,
I love it.
Okay, so today we are tapping into monogamy and polyamory, how we feel about it. I feel like even before we jump into this episode, take a wild guess who believes in what. Wow. Just take a full wild guess, because honestly, we get into a lot of stuff. I love hearing Jay's opinion about this. Mine is just a hard and fast rule, and I hear where Jay's coming from, but mine's pretty... I'm not open to much else. Jay, I love it. You're open-minded, and you foresee that it could work.
But so I think we'll open-minded, too. It's just
I'm an open-minded person to other people doing it. I'm not against you do you. I don't care. But, yeah.
Anyways, so, tap in, guys.
Tap in. Let's go. Also, you know what? Before we actually start, like, subscribe, follow. It's free. Do it. Support us.
So we're talking TikTok, YouTube, Instagram.
Yeah.
Go and follow all of that. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. We got YouTube shorts. Don't sleep on us, because we next up. Do not sleep on us.
It's all in the description. Tap in.
Let's get it. All right, guys. Welcome to the Opposites Attract podcast. I am your boy, Southwest Bully, the one and only.
And Schlex. Because I wanted to try something cool like you, and then it just didn't work. So just continue.
Stick to your day job, kids. All right, guys. So today we're going to tap into monogamy and polyamory. So I think we have opposite opinion when it comes to that. I want to hear how you feel. You're in a monogamous relationship, obviously.
Very much so. Okay, I just want to clarify something before we get into it. So, monogamy means, it just means that you're with one person, correct? It means you're in a relationship with one person.
100%.
Like polyamory is if you are in a relationship with multiple people.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So, very much so, I am in a monogamous relationship. I have one partner, and I think that is 100% what works best for us. I don't even know if I fully understand people in other relationships, and that might be a little bit, perhaps I want to say controversial, we're going to hop right into it, but I literally just don't get it. I don't get how people do it. I don't get how people want to do it.
So hold on, what are you talking about? Like open relationships or polyamory where everybody agrees to
be in a relationship with one another?
Yeah.
Either one. I don't know how people have time for this. Like I barely have time with
that one relationship.
Like not barely, like we make it very much work. But imagine actually trying to juggle multiple people. You're like, I'm about it. I'm down for it.
No, like, honestly, I've always been the monogamous type. Like, yo, I've been a serial monogamous, like, relationship to relationship. And now I'm just at a point where it's like, okay, even as I'm casually hooking up and whatever, it has to be on a monogamy standpoint, because I still can't even wrap my head around a threesome.
Yeah.
I'm like, how does that work? Do you change rubbers? Do you, what do you do? So I get it where you're coming from, where you're like, yo, I don't get it how people really wrap their head around it. But at the same time, when I look at maybe my experiences, I'm like, okay, first relationship, I wanted monogamy, committed to you, I'm dedicated to you, doesn't work out. Second, doesn't work out. Third, doesn't work out. So at one point, I'm like, does life work in a way where everybody has a season in your life? So I believe in monogamy in a sense, but at the same time, I don't believe in long-term monogamy. I believe that, yes, I believe that everybody has a season in your life. So it could be a 3-year relationship, 4, 5, 10, but you're not, there's an expiration date.
To every relationship.
The only time there's not an expiration date and there still is an expiration date is when, like, let's say we're 50, 60, 70. I got fucking diabetes and heart disease and you have a bunch of, like, issues. And then at one point, one of us dies and we were still together. Oh, they lived happily ever after until Janet died. Like, you know what I mean?
Okay.
But in my head, I'm like, especially as youngsters, like, as we're growing from teenagers to adults, whatever, like there's an expiration date.
Okay, so then where does marriage fall into this for you?
Oh, I don't believe in marriage.
Oh my gosh.
No, I don't. I don't. I think
were
as
your
a,
parents married?
Yeah, married happily? Happily.
Nice.
We're Haitian, girl. happily. No, it was in the Haitian culture, it's like they're really afraid of what people think.
Right.
So it's like yo, there's no such thing. I think the modern day Haitian, yes, now they believe in divorce and whatever, but old school Haitians, yeah, they'll ride it out.
This might be like a crazy take, but I was explaining to Mehdi the other day that more than, I think it's the percentage is, the statistic is more than 50% of marriages end in divorce. And he was like, that's not true. And I'm like, no, from North American culture, that is maybe even Western culture, even like to Europe, but it is 1,000% true. 50% of marriages end, over 50% of marriages end in divorce. And that was so hard for him to wrap his head around. And for me, I'm like, that's so normal. Like, 100%. You're more likely for the relationship to end than for it to last happily till the end, you know?
But yeah, and I obviously it's Northern.
But sorry, that was just to tap back into when you were bringing up like cultural differences, I guess.
100%.
Is that in Muslim culture, like, it doesn't really.
No, we're staying together.
Like, yeah.
Doesn't mean it's healthy.
100%.
Doesn't mean it's healthy. And I think that's where North America has this more of this ideology of like, okay, if it's unhealthy, I'm getting the fuck out.
Yeah.
Where like Haitians, Muslims, whatever, old school, immigrants, traditional, they're like.
Catholics too. Like,
exactly.
In the church, it's very much frowned upon. You're not supposed to get divorced.
100%. So for them, they're like, okay, let's just try to make it work. Yeah. And then they're unhappy when parents sleeping in one room, the other one's in another room. Like, it's whatever. But that's why for me, monogamy is like, I've always been monogamous. And even right now, like when I'm talking to a girl and I'm like, yo, listen, I can't date you. I don't have time for that right now. But let's go to the clinic. You do a test. I do a test. You're clean. I'm clean. We could keep fucking together. And it'll be a monogamy casual hookup. But until something happens, like if you fall for me or, you know, somebody else catches my eye, or if you fall in love with someone, then we end it there. But during that time that we're sleeping together, it's a monogamous relationship.
So then, okay, so tomorrow you meet this amazing girl.
Yeah.
I know you're not ready to start dating, but for example, just because you brought up the idea that you're open to the idea of polyamory.
Yeah.
Or an open relationship, for example. So a girl, you meet a girl tomorrow. You meet a girl outside. You're leaving. She's beside your car. You're helping her open the door, whatever. And she's interested in an open relationship. Like, what's your take on then an open relationship?
Okay, so now there's open relationship and polyamory. So open relationship is more like, hey, we're together. And if you end up hooking up with someone, I can't really bust your balls about it. We're in an open relationship.
But for open relationships, there's the main couple. Like, you guys are a couple, but you're just allowed.
You're basically allowed to cheat, and it's not cheating.
Okay.
So it's basically, I'm giving you a pass. We're in a relationship where we have a pass. That, I'm like, nah, that's not me. Polyamory, from what, I follow Mike Rashid. Mike Rashid had a polyamorous relationship. And
wait, you said multiple girlfriends. Like,
he had two girls. Two girls, he would show up to the podcast with them. He's with two girls. It was one black girl, one Latino girl, and then there's him. And, like, he has to take care of them equally, love them equally, give them equal attention. Like, the girls, too, they love each other, and they become one.
I think you're always going to run into so many issues, though, with something
but
like
even
that.
In a monogamous relationship.
Absolutely. It's just, but you're reducing the amount of issues that you're going to run into. You add to the party, you're going to be running in, you're going to keep, like, it's just, I feel like there's so much resistance that you're going to run into.
That's why, from
like, you're literally having to deal with double the headache. You literally have two girls. And I'm saying girls because as a woman, I would never be able to.
Yeah, but see, that's what they talk about. It's like you have to make sure there's no jealousy. Like, the two shorties got to be like, girl,
what does this guy do?
He's a fitness entrepreneur, multimillionaire, podcaster.
This is my goal. This is the guy.
I won't lie to you. Once I saw, because I love his, he's Muslim too, and his sayings, the integrity behind everything he speaks about when it comes to men, to family, you know, he has kids as well. So I really look up to him. But when he was in that polyamorous relationship, I realized, like, he seemed very happy. Yeah. They seemed very happy. You know, it's on social media. You never know. I don't know the guy personally. But it seemed very under control and a nice experience to go through. Right. I feel like I have one life to live. If I'm single and I've tried several times in the monogamous lifestyle and it didn't work out, why not give myself the chance to see what polyamory has for
me?
So if I find two females that are just like, hey, listen, like, this is my shorty. I love her. She's my girlfriend. We really fuck with you, and we want to be the best versions of ourselves together. With you.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Why not? And then at some point, it's like, yo, we obviously have to sit down and be like, okay, are you okay with this? Are you okay with that? What triggers you? There's a lot of communication, but at the same time, it's like, I don't know.
Do you have any people in your personal life? I'm trying to like tap into my experience.
That are in that?
Does anyone that I know, is anyone in a polyamorous relationship that I know? Like, I'm just speaking so, we're speaking so hypothetically.
Yeah.
I'm just kind of what we're open to, which is cool. But I love that you're open to it because I would never. Really. And I just feel like I know myself. I would just, maybe it's because I want the attention fully on myself. Maybe it's because I want the time fully to myself. Even referring back to our last podcast, the one we were talking about, where a lot of people had stuff to say about this, about
being the second option
to the husband, for example, the single dad, being the second option to the children. Having another woman in the mix, I'm like, it would never.
You can't say never. Well, obviously you're in a happy relationship. And I think you guys are going to get married the way it's going and his traditional and like his ways. Yeah. But I'm just saying that for me, the way I see it is that, let's say if I meet two girls that have the same ideology as I have, they don't believe, like I had a client and she was telling me, she's like, I don't believe that monogamy. Like, I don't believe you're meant for one person. And I truly believe that you're not meant for one person. There's 7 billion motherfuckers, even more, 8 billion motherfuckers on the face of earth. You're gonna tell me you're meant for one person? I'm like, hey, I fall in love today in Montreal, Quebec, Chabanel district. Hold on, let me finish, girl. I fall in love in Chabanel district today. You're telling me I've been to Miami, I've been to Lebanon, I've seen New York, everything. You're going to tell me that there's not another person that's compatible to me that I could fall in love with and have an amazing season with?
No one's denying that.
So that's why we believe that, okay, monogamy is that I find that one person and I just lock the lock and throw away the key and we're together forever.
Because if that person, and we're together
like, what?
But then if you're, okay, so then if you have, like, if you're thinking this, you meet this girl, then she's your soulmate.
Uh-huh.
Does everyone have one soulmate? Or you have multiple soulmates?
Multiple.
And I know everyone's, like, definition on soulmates can differ 1,000%. But in terms, because you could have a friend that's a soulmate, you could have, like, there's different, I guess, ways of thinking about it.
100%.
But in your eyes, there's another soulmate out there for you.
100%. Because I feel like as you evolve as a human being, like, let's say a teenager that goes through his all the teenage trauma and in French, they say crise d'adolescence. Mm-hmm. Like you go through your whole whatever. And then when you become early 20s, mid 20s, you're totally different
from
25. Compare your 18-year-old self to your 25-year-old self.
No.
What you used to fuck with and love at 18 was compatible to whoever you had as a partner back then. Then 25, you done changed up, girl.
Yeah.
I'm turning 31 in June. So it's like who I was when I was 25 or like even 22 is completely different. And
there's different things you want.
There's different things I want. So now I realize that like, oh, okay. So I have seasons. Yeah. I have certain times where I'm a different person. I basically die and come back to life. Die in your life, whether you live 50 years, 60 years, 70 years, I feel like you die and you resurrect.
Yeah.
So I'm like, but how the fuck can one person be mine for all those? I'm changing up. The only way is if you are on the same wavelength in a sense, or like on the same vibration where it's like, okay, you're growing with me, but even then we are growing apart. We're two individuals that come together to make a team. So it's like,
so I actually you're opening my mind to that, because everything you just said I actually do very much agree with. But once you do find that one person, and you, because now I'm 25, so when you were making that reference between 18 and 25, I 1,000% agree. I always say, if people, I was so different when I was 18.
Yeah.
As you know, but I was so different when I was 18.
100%.
I did not like the same things. I was not into the same things. I made horrible decisions. Obviously, it has to do with immaturity as well.
Yeah, but you're going through it. You're learning stuff.
And grow so much. But I always say, if people did not find forgiveness in me when I was 18, I was making such bad decisions. Like, family, friends, if people didn't forgive me, I'm such a firm believer that people change. Such a firm believer.
Oh,
like, some people are like, people can change. 1,000% people can change. I am 1,000,000% different than where I was and who I was, excuse me, when I was 18. Okay, so I actually agree with what you're saying.
Yes.
But once you do find that one person,
so you
and if it does make sense, and if it does last. You're like, this is my person for a lifetime, which is literally how I feel about money. And do you believe in that? Do you think?
I've had that feeling.
And then it changed something.
And it switched up. So for me, it's like, okay, now, like I'm 31, turning 31. I'm like, am I really going to go through this whole, like I want to be
the person. What if a girl wants to get married though? The one that you find.
Yo, it's like, what if a girl wants to have another kid? I ain't having another kid.
It's not happening.
It's not happening. If you want to get married, I'm not saying that I will not get married. I just believe, I don't believe in that business contract. I'm like,
it's
if you.
For taxes though.
Whatever. until she wants to take half of your shit. Like, nah, bro. Taxes, what? Honestly, if I meet a shorty that wants to get married, she got her shit going. She's like, yo, brother, I want you to take care of me. I got my own, but I want you to take care of me. I want to be in my divine femininity where I could just kick back, sit pretty, and like you go and chase your purpose and be a man and be a provider, be a protector. But we don't need to get it on contract. We don't have to have it on paper because I'm not trying to take half of your shit. I want to live this moment with you and grow with you and experience this marriage with you. That, I'm up for it. But most people that want to get married, it's like, oh, let's get it on paper. Oh, let's do this. Then I got to get a prenup. I got to get a prenup. And then you're like, oh, why do you want a prenup? And then it just fucks everything up.
Yeah, I'm all for the prenup, I think.
I think it's, yeah, it is. It is important, but it's like,
oh, it's so
but,
not romantic. I'm like, no.
Okay, but you see, so you're already going into your business contract, your marriage, saying, it might fuck up. Chances are it will. Let's get a prenup.
Yeah.
You understand what I mean? So it's like, why even believe in this whole monogamy idea if you can just be like, you know what? Hey, I just met this girl. She's amazing. We vibe together. Yeah. Let's experience this part of our life together. Make the most of it. I will respect you. I will love you. I will be loyal to you. But when that bell rings and we got to head to class or check out, let's check out. That's how
and
I see it.
An easier separation. Do you not think that it would be a hindrance anyway if you were in that polyamorous relationship? You have those multiple partners, but you are inherently then allocating your resources where it could be all like time, energy, money, all towards that one partner, that one female, that one woman. And you're, I don't want to say spreading yourself too thin, but you're dividing it amongst two women then. Like if you're really pouring into that one cup, you're pouring into that one relationship, you have everything going into that one person. Do you not think it has so much more of an opportunity to flourish then?
If you're focused on one person?
Yeah. Like you have so much more of like so much more likely of a higher rate of success of the relationship if that's your goal for it to be a long-term relationship, to all your time, all your energy, all your money is going to this one woman. And I can, again, going back into history, like that's, I understand that polyamory was important because we were trying to populate. So a man, it was normal to have multiple partners. Their goal was then
but
to
even
have children, to have children with multiple partners. Now, I guess perhaps I want to say it's more progressive. I'm not 100% sure, but you're going to be spending your time, money, energy, everything with multiple women.
Okay, so.
So how are you? How is that going to last then?
But once again, I'm not saying that for me, going into a polyamorous relationship, I'm not looking for it to last. I'm looking for the experience. I'm looking for the freedom of experiencing something that society tells you not to.
Okay.
I think that's what's dope about it. And at the same time.
This society tells you not to.
Yeah, this society, there's but other there's other ones that are like, yo, let's,
all for it.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Fuck with that.
You're like, but, it's, you're weird. You have one.
yeah, they're like, what are you doing, bro? But at the same time, let's go back to back in time when men, and like, we're still like this, but society has caged us up. A man cannot only be with one woman. This is about to shake up the room, but it's true. A man is designed to want more than one partner.
Okay, and where do women stand there?
But women, it's like, I feel like women are programmed to nurture and want to make some that one thing work. And men are just more like, hey, I'd like to experience. Because men also have this, they don't associate, like let's say, example, if a man cheats, most of the time they weren't emotionally attached to the person they cheated with. It was their testosterone level, that urge, that sexual urge of having another, that animal instinct of having another partner. Now, I'm not saying that cheating is okay. I do not condone in cheating. I'm just saying, like, if we look at human nature, how the female is and how the male is, men, they're lions. They want to just, okay,
so
let
you
me.
You think it's innate? It's
in us. It's just that now
and
we
have to actively work towards not doing it.
And that's where I feel like I respect the man that controls his sexual urges. It shows a sign of discipline. So I'm a firm believer in like, yo, if you can't control your sexual urges, I can't trust you. But if we look back, that's why me, polyamory is something that's cool because...
Like, it just seems more natural.
It seems more natural because I could literally, I have two partners that I'm being honest with. Mm-hmm. My integrity is still showing, but I'm able to be the lion, the king of the jungle, like, yeah. I'm supposed to be.
Like, I just, yeah.
I could tap into really, and that's just because I stand on integrity. I stand on honesty. So if I have 2-3 girls that are like, hey, let's be in a relationship. Mm-hmm. We fuck with you. We want to be your partners, and we think that you're the perfect king to our kingdom. Like, let's do it.
Yeah.
And at least I'm not in a monogamy relationship neglecting my natural urges and then cheating on my wife and then breaking her natural instinct yeah. of being a nurturer and wanting to build and submit to her man.
Yeah.
Because naturally women want to submit to a man that's able to provide, to give, to protect.
Yeah.
When they have that security in a man, a woman will submit. She will dive into her femininity and submit to that man. But then it's like, shit, she can get that, but a man can't really get that opportunity of, okay, I want to feel like, yes, I have that woman I love, but shit, I want to go and experience this type of female, this type of person. No.
As a man, as a provider, as a protector, as a leader.
Yeah.
Where does that leave if you have 2, 3, 4 women? Is it not, aren't you just literally just giving yourself
Because we're all on the same page. That's the beauty of, from what I understand, we still have to look into it more. From what I understand, that's the beauty of polyamory, because it's like, we're all agreeing to this. We're all on the same page. We're going to dinner together. We're going to bed together. Yo, we're taking a shower, a bath together. We're eating breakfast together. We go shopping together. We do everything together.
Okay. And where do kids fall into this?
That's the touchy
that's
part.
That's where
I'm like, okay, now, why I'm not jumping into something like that, or why I wouldn't expose it to, like, my children, because do I want my daughter to see me as, or have an idea that a man shouldn't value her?
Yeah.
But at the same time, I'm like...
It's okay for you to do it.
But that's not what I'm saying. I know, this is really touchy. That's not what I'm saying, though. I'm just saying, like, she's young right now. I want her to make her own ideas.
Absolutely.
And, like,
no,
right now,
that, yeah,
they're
yeah.
kids. So, like, just because, like, I see my son. Mm-hmm. I'm in the park with him. And, like, yo, I spit on the floor sometimes. It is what it is. Especially if I'm sick, I have to spit. So
I
spit and I don't realize. And then he goes, and he tries to spit, too. And I'm like, Kai Kai, don't do that.
Yeah.
Like, don't do like that. No. So they're sponges.
As I say, not as I do.
They're sponges right now. So I want my daughter to become her own person and be maybe like you and be like, hey, I believe in monogamy and not polyamory. But at least at that point...
Do you think the monogamy is better for women?
No, I don't.
Okay.
I think if a woman wants to be in a polyamorous relationship, go.
Yeah.
You want to be the boss and have... You want to be the queen and have 2 dudes? Do your thing, girl.
Okay.
As long as... I believe in integrity.
Yeah.
You're showing up and you're honest.
Yeah.
That's why monogamy, I'm like, hey, you're caged up in a sense where it's like, at one point, okay, you guys are not sleeping together because a lot of things are unsaid, boom, boom, boom. And then you see that beautiful girl that you work with or whatever, or she sees that her work bae, and it's like, the urges are there, but then you're blocking those urges and then it's more tension in the relationship.
Okay, but did you feel this? I'm like giving this as an interview too. I love this episode because I love hearing what you have to say, and I'm such a...
Have I felt that?
Because I'm just bringing it back to myself and I'm just thinking, even at work, like in my relationship, I, hand to God,
G-O-D.
Have never, ever thought about, like, and I'm not even just saying this because it's around the world, never thought about anyone else. And I'm saying that because perhaps it's because you're not in a relationship right now. When you were in past relationships, did you feel that way? Because
100%.
In my current relationship, that you're form like just a monogamous relationship when you're in that relationship, or you were thinking at the time, oh, I think I could tap into my polyamory.
Not that I could tap into my polyamory because I wasn't aware of what polyamory was.
Okay.
But in my monogamous relationship, at one point, things, it's like we've been together for a while. Sometimes girls get comfortable. They don't take care of themselves as much. And then like whatever. And then at one point, it's just like, shit, like... I was at work.
But seeing in a woman's feminine energy, I'm just thinking, like, that's, I want to say her job or her role, but, like, that's important for her to stay on. So
on fleek.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, so on fleek, yeah. And then that's why it's like, but sometimes it's like maybe she has a lot of things that are unsaid and she's not happy, so it's reflecting through the way she's taking care of herself.
Right.
Is she taking 2 showers a day or just 1?
Right.
Like, things like that. So at one point it's like, I'm easily turned off, like, So at one point it's like, yeah, it's like it doesn't have to be physically.
Do you know what that means?
No.
I knew it. It's like a thing. It's like, what are your icks? It's like random things.
Oh, ugh.
It's like, ugh.
Yeah. Like me, it's the icks that come up that could turn me off from a female is...
So minor.
It's minor, and it's like, it's not minor. It's very mental. I need to be stimulated before I, like, physically, obviously, attraction, it's the number one thing, but... Yeah. If you can't stimulate my mind, like if you can't hold a conversation, or if you can't challenge my thoughts, or if you're making a bunch of excuses, if you're lazy, if you're this, I will not touch you.
Absolutely.
You show me that you're lazy, you snooze in the morning and you don't get up and you're blaming everything else but your actions. Yo, I can't sleep with you.
Yeah.
It's way before you start taking only one shower and you're not doing your hair no more, you're not doing your nails. I'm checked out way before that. So obviously at one point it's like, fuck, I see the girl that's taking care of herself, that shows up to the gym, that's very disciplined with her schedule, that's outgoing. Oh, damn. That's sexy to me.
Yeah, it's turn on.
It's turning me on. Like, so I don't know. I felt it before, and that's why I'm at a point where I'm like, fuck, if I felt it, and usually women, when they're in a relationship, and then at one point it's like, it's falling apart, they already know who's next.
Yeah.
So you are feeling it too. You were feeling it too, but it's just we have this society gives us the standard that, okay, you cannot just go and just sleep with someone while you're in a relationship or start entertaining someone else. Where in polyamory, it's like, hey, I like you. I like you. Y'all like me. Let's get it popping.
Yeah.
And it's cool. But I don't know how it ends up. I don't feel like, see, I was following Mike Rashid and he's not with the girls no more.
Oh, well then.
So I'm like, ugh, did that work out?
Like,
or?
Like you said, it just reinstates exactly what you said.
Expiration date.
And different seasons of your life.
100%. So I think he was in that season.
I know. My season's very long with Medi.
Oh, 100%. I wish that everyone could have a long-term season. Yeah. Even for myself, when that next shorty comes up,
because
wherever you're at, I hope we have a long season. I hope we could see each other grow into different people and adapt as we move. But in reality... girl.
He's waiting. No, I'm just kidding.
I love you. No, but I mean, like, at the end of the day, I just feel like there's an expiration date.
Yeah.
From what I see, if it's on TV, relationships I know about, coworkers, clients, myself, there's an expiration date, and that's okay. That's where you could go into a relationship and really be your real self and enjoy the ride.
Yeah.
That's monogamy to me right now. I'm still open to monogamy. If I meet a girl and I'm down with her, it's like, yo, let's do this. But I'm not like, don't talk to me about weddings and everything. I'm like, yo, let's see where we get.
It's just to me that one, the idea of monogamy and what I like love about it, I guess, and I'm sure you would agree, but it's just having those experiences and memories and everything with that one person.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like just doing things like you hear, like even if I talk to some of my girlfriends and then you just go away on vacation with this guy and go away with that guy and go away, do this and do these really cool things with different people. And then it's, you come back home and it's like, oh yeah. Like, I want to just like be up in bed with someone. And it's like,
yeah, did this I'm doing life with you.
Together. I'm doing life with you.
Exactly. Yeah, 100%. And I'm all for it.
I love that idea of building with that one person. If there's an expiration date, it's kind of having that mentality already right off the bat is that you have one foot in, you already have one foot out. So you can never fully give yourself to that person. And I think there's so much beauty in that.
No, I disagree.
You know?
I disagree.
Okay, go.
I disagree because it's not, I don't think it's one foot in, one foot out. I think it's just you're being realistic in a point where it's like anything could happen, but right now where we're at, I'm gonna make the best out of it. So I'm going to enjoy that when we wake up in bed. I'm going to enjoy when we travel. I'm going to enjoy those deep conversations we have late at night over wine.
It's literally in the back of your head that this relationship, I don't know when, it could be 5, 10, 15 years, but this is not my person that's going to be with me beside me on my deathbed, is what you're saying.
No, I'm saying that you're my person in the season that I'm in at the moment. So right now I'm in a season where it's like, yo, self-care, Jay. I'm taking care of myself. I'm getting my finances right. I'm getting my new businesses off the ground, closing my old business. I'm in a focus mode. If I find a girl that's in the same mindset, she's focused. She's focused on herself. She's dedicated. She wakes up early. She does this. She does that.
Yeah.
Let's enjoy that season together. Let's come together and enjoy that. At one point, if
I'm telling you,
I never
want
to.
Thinking that is one foot in, one foot out.
No.
That's exactly what it means because it's in your subconscious.
They say.
This relationship, no, you are not dying with this person.
I don't believe in dying with one person. That doesn't exist.
Okay, so then we're going back to it. That is not your goal then. that is not your goal. If you have in your mind, like, I'm like, okay, I get to make these memories with Mehdi. I am get to go on vacation with you. I'm going to go meet your parents. I'm giving all to this. I want to build an empire with you. I want to build businesses with you. I want to invest in businesses together. I want to buy this building together. I want to do this together.
I want that.
That's not happening.
I want that.
Okay, but that's not going to happen if you literally are like, okay, this, again, it could be 5, it could be 10, it could be 15 years, it could be 5, it could be 10, it could be 15 months. There is an expiration date is what you're saying. I want to give my all to this person. I'm ready to give it. I'm ready to go to bat for you. And I'm not saying you're not ready to go to bat for the two girls that you're going to be with or that you're open to being with.
Hey, I didn't say I was going
to
get into
it. No, I know, but you're open. You're open to that idea. Yeah, and I love that. But I'm just, there's just so much value in pouring into that one cup together, in my opinion.
Yeah, but it takes two to tangle. And what's unfortunate about monogamy is that sometimes, you can wake up tomorrow and your mind just switch. Especially women. Women are.
Hold on.
Yes, especially women, because think about it. Hormones going up and down. Like, men get, I think men, no, listen, men get like one menstrual cycle. Like, hold on. Men get one cycle. We wake up every day with that boost of testosterone. Women don't. Women get that maybe once a month, and it's like that little like 3 days or maybe a week. So their emotions are all over the place, and we need to embody that and appreciate that and respect that. But at the same time, it's scary for a man because it's like, okay, I have my purpose. I have my vision. I know what I want to do. I want to build with this woman, this, that, that. But tomorrow, because her hormones were up and down and something shifted, it can shift her whole perspective and her decision-making. So at that point, it's like, fuck, I'm putting all my eggs in one basket. Baby girl, you might switch on me.
Okay, but listen.
You might switch on me,
There's one thing.
I was doing it for me and you. Listen,
there's one thing, though, that's so fun about these cycles that you're talking about.
Yeah.
Is that those cycles, well, for the most part.
Forever. Yeah.
But they are one of the very few constants of a woman. So if you're able to tap into those cycles, it's never going to change.
And that's where you're going
into it aware, okay, you know what? Like, it's a roller coaster, but it's the most consistent roller coaster in the sense of that there's literal timings for it. I'm not saying you have to act your whole life based on these cycles at all, but I'm just saying, like, those cycles will never change. You can always go into
it. But I'm not saying the cycles are changing. I'm saying the decision-making, it influences your decision-making.
Within those 4 weeks, that's when it could change. But that 4 weeks is going to happen again and again and again and again.
Yeah, but the decision-making within those 4 weeks are going to happen again and again. Because let's say, okay, I don't know what happens. Something outside of our relationship happens. And then it changes the person's perspective. Yeah. Her perspective will change as she's going through that cycle.
So I'm
going
to challenge you here.
Go, challenge me,
girl. Why? Then, so then you're going into a relationship under the impression that you are, because of these cycles, because of these changing decisions, you're already ready.
No, because I haven't found the person that I'm like, you know what? I'm going to risk it all for you. And I will, mic drop.
I haven't found the right person.
That shorty comes and she's like, yo, baby, I will embrace every season. Tomorrow, you want to cheat on me? Cheat on me, baby.
No,
but you know what I'm saying? No, I'm not like that. But it's just more like, okay, you know what? I will study accurately. I will know by heart your seasons and your cycles and what you go through. And I will make sure, because a man is very strategic, a man is very smart, and you could find a way to adapt and be compatible to her seasons. All I'm saying is that you enter into a relationship, going back to our old episode, where I say people are always on their best behavior. When you meet someone, you want to impress them. You want them to really like you. Once you get comfortable,
you should have your best habits. Yeah.
The things, you see some shit that comes out, you're like, oh, I didn't know you were like that. So I'm just trying to really, I hope, and I truly know, and I'm manifesting it, I will find that partner that, like, okay, your integrity, your honesty, everything was there from the jump. And as you're going through your season, I know who I'm dealing with. Yeah. There's no surprise.
But you know what I mean? I know, I understand what you're saying, but then you want to talk about studying and polyamory, multiple people, like understanding, and like I said, wanting to pour into that one person, for example, it's a lot easier to study and fully understand and fully comprehend that one person. So if you're ready, again, I understand the appeal of having the two, whatever, the three, whatever it may be. But if you want to talk about studying cycles of someone and wanting to fully understand, that's what I'm saying about tapping into your resources and wanting to allocate all those resources. That takes time, that takes energy to fully understand someone, to fully appreciate someone, their flaws, everything about them. What that takes, it takes time, it takes energy, and like I said, money. Do that into one person.
Okay, but you've never, going to college, uni, whatever, you've never had a group of homies, like girlfriends? Like I could say, I could just tell you the girls at the club that you chill with. You guys are literally in sync. You guys are on the same wavelength. It's like you think the same, you see things the same, perspective are similar. And you guys get along. You could spend the whole day in the same room.
Because of our upbringing?
No, just in general. Like there's something called compatibility and organic chemistry.
Okay.
So I believe that I've never been in a polyamorous relationship, but from what I understand and what I think it could be is that organically, we're on the same page. Organically, there's not like, oh, I need to really like pour into you. No, we're pouring into each other. It's just like we're in sync.
But the in sync takes work.
No, because it's organically, it just came.
So you're telling me you don't think a relationship is work?
Oh, I think a relationship is a lot of work.
So that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, it's a lot
of
work.
But it's that time and energy to do that with someone. To do these things with someone. I know it's organically, like of course naturally there's a natural spark amongst the two people, whatever it may be.
Yeah.
But it is active work. Imagine how to put that active work into two separate people, into three separate people.
To me, it's like, yo, listen, the best example I could give you is like, you wanna be rich, it's gonna be hard. You wanna be broke, it's gonna be hard. You wanna be mediocre, that's gonna be hard. Mm-hmm. You wanna be successful, it's gonna be hard. You wanna be in a monogamous relationship, it's going to be hard. You want to be in a polyamorous relationship, it's going to be hard. Mm-hmm. Pick your motherfucking heart. Right now, I'm at a point where I'm like, yes, you know what? I'm going to try this hard. See how that works.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. That's true.
Like, I don't think it's polyamory is very present in Montreal.
For sure.
Yeah, but that's like swingers. Like, that's different. I'm not talking about that weird, like, we're super wealthy and let's go swing. I want to see you fuck my husband. Like, no, I'm not talking about that shit. I'm just talking about, like, we genuinely vibe. Like, the energy you have with Mehdi or I've had with several women, just, it's like a triangle. It's a love triangle.
You know what I mean? I wanted mine to be a circle.
Yeah, I'm down.
You're ready for the triangle.
I'm ready for the triangle. Like, I'm just open to trying the triangle. I'm not saying I'm ready for it. Yeah. I don't think I'm equipped with the tools and the. I think
you
I'm still
self-aware king.
Yeah, the self-aware. I don't. I'm not. I don't think I'm ready for it. I just think like as we're talking about
I'm open to the idea of having two shorties.
I think I'm open to the idea because as a man. And I like when you really try to understand what a man is and what a woman is, like as a man, I can speak more about being a man. I won't start talking and saying like I know what being a woman is. I'm still learning and understanding. But as a man, it's like, yo, we're like the king of the jungle. We thrive off taking over the world and challenges and accomplishing things and like our purpose and our drive. And also we are waking up every day with a new boost of testosterone. Testosterone is your main hormone that stimulates your muscle growth, your sex drive, like everything. So imagine if I wake up every day like a fucking stallion and it's like, oh, I can experience this female. I can experience this one. I can experience this one. And it's like women are so beautiful. And like for me, that's the issue. It's like I look at women like, wow, you are amazing.
Yeah.
I want to lick every inch of your body because you are beautiful. You don't really look at men like that. They're hairy. They're fucking, they smell bad. Like, it's not really like that. But women, it's like they walk in a room and you're like, you don't even fart. I want to know what you're about. What's and I feel like there's so many, like the population, yeah, Temant Belle Femme, there's so many beautiful women. Yeah, it's like, true. I would love to experience every type
all of you.
Of,
I just want to all of you,
all of you. But I want to experience
every
you.
Every single one of you.
The thing is that I want to experience every single one of you, not in a way where it's like, misogynist or like, oh, I'm just trying to smash and pass. Yeah. No, I really, I want to sit down actually. With you. Yeah. I want to hear your way of thinking. I want to hear what scares you, what hurts you, what are your fears, what are your insecurities, what makes you
dream about?
Yeah, what makes you go crazy in life and what makes you motivated to just wake up every day. I want to hear everything about you and I want to make love to you. And then at the same time, oh, your homegirl, she's dope too. I want to know what's up with her. Come on in, you know what I mean? Enjoy the fun.
Why is she waiting in the car?
Straight up. Yeah, I thought it'd come through. But that's the thing, is I have an approach.
More like you.
I feel like I could really do the polyamory thing because I have an approach where it's like, my whole life I've been good with women. Like, I've been like, as a kid, I was in the best, but I mean, like, as I grew into a man, I understood that, like, I have great relationship with women. Like, I have, you're one of my girlfriends. Like, we're super chill. Like, I can meet a girl and I'm like, I never come off as the thirsty, like, oh, I'm trying to smash type of dude. I'm not like that. Yeah. I don't run after women, but I love experiencing deep conversations with women, and I think that's a beautiful thing. And then right then there's like that sexual energy where it's like, okay, what would it be if I would sleep with you? So it's like, to me right now, that's where my head is at. It's like, you know, and I've told you before, it's like I already get that love from my children.
Yeah,
so it's hard for me to just be like, oh, monogamy, let's, yeah, you know what I mean?
I am.
So yeah, that was crazy. That was dope.
Last thing that I want to bring up is that it's not necessarily even your opinion. It's just a greater understanding that might encapsulate all of this, is that it really does come down to the fact that women do, like, women's ability to reproduce is limited. So a lot of what we're saying does significantly apply just to men. You understand what I'm saying? So I understand why, let me just say, I understand why I feel the way I do.
Yes,
you feel the way you
okay.
do. It's very scientific. It's what it comes down to.
So you see where I'm at? Okay.
No, I'm just saying, this whole episode is just me being like, I could never do it. I have so many reasons why I don't necessarily believe in it. But when you go back to the past, it's when we were trying to reproduce and we were trying to populate everything. Men can go to multiple women and have children with multiple women. And on dirait, it's unlimited. Your resources are tied up, like I said, because you come to not infinite money, not infinite energy, not infinite
for sure,
all this
for
stuff.
Sure.
But women, you could never do that. So that's why I think a lot of the time it is structured in the way that it is one man, multiple women.
And that's why, I'm going back
to,
that's human nature. And it's not to be like, once again, some people are going to be such a misogynist. He thinks women can't do it. If you have that in you.
Sound off in the comments.
Yo, like, if you have, just do your thing. If you have that in you as a woman, 100%. I'm not going to be the guy that's going to be like, women can't do that. If you feel like you could and you're open about it, I stand on integrity. You want to be a hoe? Be a hoe. You want to be a dog, but be real about it.
Yeah, facts.
You know what I mean? So, but I was trying to really base it off. Yo, the lion in the kingdom.
Yeah.
He needs to go and reproduce.
But yeah, if we're going to bring, like you said, the animals
that's what
into
I'm going
it,
by.
It's innately, it's it, like,
that's
what
it
comes
is.
Down
exactly.
to. 100%. And then you're going to come back to the providing, the lion goes out.
He's the one hunting. He's the one, you know what I mean?
I'm like, I hear you.
And even if the lioness goes and hunts, she will go and hunt and come back, and she wants to be submissive to the lion. She wants to be submissive to her man, knowing that he's the king of the jungle. And that's
and
just
we'll
what
take
it
care
is.
Of her.
It's like women right now, it's like they want a man that could provide, that's financially stable. If I'm broke and bummy, you're not dating me.
Fucks.
You know what I mean? But if I have my finances straight, my career straight, my emotional intelligence straight, you will just lay back and be daddy. Do what you gotta do. And that's going back to being an animal. It's like, it's still there. It's just now it's different in modern day. So that's why I'm saying polyamory makes sense to me, and I get it how it doesn't make sense to you. Who wants to
have
be my,
fun. Yeah, I was
my two shorties?
I saw them as bullies.
Yeah, straight up, hit me.